Hello everyone, this is Gaurav Jain, going to teach you IP, that is Informatic Practices for class 11th. This is our first chapter, Computer Overview. My first question is, what is computer system? A computer is an electronic device that accepts data as input, process it according to the specific rules or program, produce the information as output and store the information for future use. Because of these different units work as a single unit in a computer for common objective. That's why it's called a system, means computer system. I hope all of you understand the definition of computer system. Now move to the next topic, that is data and information. What is data? Data are the raw facts and figures, which has no meaning. And information means when we process the data, it becomes information. Means the data that converted into a meaningful and useful context is information. So here is a basic computer organization. It's a structure of computer. Like input devices sends the data to the CPU. CPU processes it and goes to the output device. Then output device display the result. The CPU has three portions. Three major parts: CU is control unit, ALU is arithmetic and logical unit, and MU is memory unit. So the next topic, that is input devices. Devices which are used to enter data in the computer's memory is called input devices. For example, keyboard, mouse, joystick, light pen, scanner, trackball, microphone, etc. Output devices are the devices which are used to give the output or results. For example, monitor, projector, printer, etc. Let's explain them. Then some of input devices are keyboard. Keyboard is an input device which sends the data to the computer. The data is sent with the help of key pressing. Next is the mouse. A mouse is a small handheld input device which is used to send the data with the help of clicks. It has two clicks, the right click and the left click. Two buttons are there and one scroll button is there. It is used to scroll the window. Next is scanner. Scanner means it scans the document and save it to the computer memory in the digital form. OMR is the optical mark recognition or optical mark reader. It is used to read the marks on the document. Means when the competitive exams, we have to fill the OMR sheets, right? These sheets are used to read by the OMR reader, optical mark reader, which reads the sheets and sends the data to the computer. That's why it's an input device. Next is OCR, optical character recognition, optical character reader. It's an input device which reads the printed text and save the text to the computer's memory. MICR, magnetic ink character recognition or magnetic ink character reader. It's an input device which is generally finds in the bank. It is used to process the checks. It is used to basically read the magnetic characters printed on the checks. Microphone, it receives the audio from the user and save it to the computer. So these are the input devices. Now it comes to the next topic, that is output devices. First device is monitor. Monitor is the common output devices which is responsible for receiving the data from a computer and displaying the information as text or images for the users to see. And the output produced on the monitor is called soft copy. Speakers. Speakers are used to receive the sound signals from the computer and plays. We can hear the music or songs with the help of speakers. Projector. Projector gets the data from the computer and display it on a very big screen or wall. Next is the printer. It gets the data from a computer and prints on a paper. That's why its output is known as hard copy. Next is central processing unit, the main brain of the computer. A CPU consists of three parts, ALU, CU, and memory. ALU is arithmetic and logical unit which performs basic arithmetic operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication and division, and logical operations such as add or not. Most modern ALU have small amount of special storage units called registers for the fast data accessing. Then the main memory. CU is control unit which controls all the functions done by a computer system, all the input functions, processing functions and the output functions. And memory is used to store the data. Basically, a collection of cells is called a memory, and each cell has a unique physical address. And mostly computers are the byte addressable, means the memory are measured in bytes. So there are two types of memories, primary memory and secondary memory. We can discuss it later. Let's discuss the units of memory. The smallest unit of memory is called bit, that is binary digit, which consists of two characters, that is 0 or 1. Okay, 4 bits are called 1 nibble, 8 bits consist of 1 byte. Then the cycle of 1024 is there, 1024 bytes, 1 kilobyte, 1024 kilobyte, 1 megabyte, 1024 megabyte, 1 gigabyte, 1024 gigabyte, 1 terabyte, and 1024 terabyte, 1 petabyte, and so on. There are several memory units or more. We can cover the rest topics in the next lecture. Thank you for watching. Stay home, stay safe.